what a peaceful creature of the sea. Like a quiet worm laying on the sidewalk after it rains, kissing its friends as they pass by. Oh look, it's with a friend. Aw, look at that baby lamprey.
Just kidding! Lampreys are crazy, crazy crazy. Deem the vampires of the sea. Let's take a look about the sheer reality of these crusty old parasitic creatures. Part 1. What is a lamprey? The lamprey is a nasty-looking creature. They aren't eels, but rather are an eel-like aquatic jawless vertebrate that has a sucker mouth with horny teeth and a rasping tongue. They're also sometimes called nine-eyed eels, since they have 7 gill slits, an eye, and nostril. They are anadromous, meaning they hatch and grow in freshwater, then they migrate to the ocean to mature, and then go back to the freshwater to lay eggs. It is a parasitic creature that attaches itself to other fish and sucks their blood and body for hours. Yum. They can eat up to 40 pounds of fish in their lifetime, and only about 1 in every 7 fish survive a lamprey attack. Lampreys don't have a sympathetic nervous system, scales, and a spleen. Their teeth are in their jawless mouths and attach onto it as it feeds. Lamprey saliva has anticoagulants to keep the blood fluid. Some of them eat flesh and blood. Lampreys can range from 12 to 20 inches in length and weigh about 8 to 13 ounces. Lamprey eggs hatch into small larvae known as amosoites. Since they are not predators yet, they survive by trapping food with their mucus. It takes about 7 years for amosoites to develop into adults. They are bottom feeders that live on the bottom of muddy rivers. They have no eyes, so finding other creatures to suck on is their last priority. Adult lampreys live from 1 to 2 years, then they reproduce and die. They are grayish blue-black in color and have metallic violet on their sides and silver and white on their undersides. They are usually found in the North Atlantic coast and are common in the Great Lakes region and the River Reef.
Part 2, evolutionary roots. Since there are rarely any lamprey fossils, most likely due to their lack of bones, it's hard to find out its evolutionary roots. Michael Coates, associate professor in organismal biology and anatomy, stated, "These are pretty insubstantial animals. Lacking a bony skeleton, they rot down, leaving no hard parts like a skull or ribs." According to a study from the University of Chicago, lampreys have shown little evolutionary variation in over 360 million years. Lampreys are the few representatives of the early branches of vertebrate evolution that are still around today. They evolved before vertebrates and jaws were present in organisms. Again, since lampreys don't have bones, fossils are super hard to find. The oldest record of a fossil is 35 million years old and is outlined by the imprint of soft tissue. Scientists can learn more about the evolutionary origin of vertebrates. For instance, brain development in vertebrates. Researchers from California Institute of Technology have been studying lampreys, specifically the hindbrain of a lamprey, to try to conclude whether or not Hox genes are involved in patterning of the lamprey hindbrain. By studying lampreys in this manner, gathering knowledge of the lamprey hindbrain that may be conserved in modern vertebrates, it's information that will help contribute to a fundamental understanding of vertebrate development.
Part 3, the dissection. Materials you need: scissors, scalpel, green scalpel, gloves, goggles, and the tray. Now this is the anterior dorsal fin. This is the posterior dorsal fin, the caudal fin. And when you flip it over, you see the mouth. The trunk. And the cloacal aperture.
When you zoom in on the butt.
And when you flip it over, you can see the eyes and the nostril. And the external gill slits. And here's the external gill slits on the other side. know, this is the mouth, and you can see the horny teeth.
They're horny.
And you can see the buccal papulae, the feelers on the outside of the mouth. And that's the tongue. And now we begin the dissection. Now what we did was we cut the lamprey in half from the top.
Hey, Mr. Balecki! The lamprey's in your pants. Would you rather... Wait, what was the thing? Would you rather smell like... Would you rather smell like a lamprey for the rest of your life,
or have
to put a lamprey in your pants every day for 10 minutes? Oh, yeah,
thought-provoking question.
Yeah. Thought-provoking question. Thought-provoking question.
All right, now for some freestyle.
Woo! Hey, Mr. Kamlerky. That's not our teacher.
God, how do you even handle it at this point?
You got this.
I took off my gloves.
Okay.
Oh, I got electrocuted.
Hot. You did?
I literally did.
Oh my God.
I didn't get electrocuted.
Liz, how are you feeling? How are you feeling, Liz?
Gross. Stuff.
Okay. When you're not in our group.
What the heck?
You got it. You got this. Okay. Come on. Come on, Lance, help! Give us a little push!
Oh, sorry!
I was done!
Just how you feeling?
Honestly?
Yeah, that's
what.
Are you sliding the scissors?
No.
Imagine, these are like two legs.
Oh, it's a mermaid.
So, you know, we're just cutting that thing in half. It took a while. It took about 2 days. So let's just keep watching. Bear with us right now. All right, this is me getting to the tail part, and I struggled a lot. Okay, I know that looks really unorthodox how I'm cutting, but I swear to God, I was trying really hard.
No. Last final rip. Rip. Praise.
Don't touch me. Part 4, relationship between function and structure. The lamprey has an intestine, liver, kidney, tongue, spinal cord, gills, pineal eye, nostril, brain, ovary, heart, muscle, tentacle, pharynx, and more. The lamprey's digestive system is made up of an alimentary canal, which runs from the mouth to the anus. The way it works is that food goes into the mouth and travels through the pharynx into the esophagus. Since lampreys don't have stomachs, the food directly goes from the esophagus straight to the intestine, which takes in most of the nutrients. The intestine is the site of the emulsification, digestion, and absorption of nutrients. The latter portion of the intestine digests bacteria, reabsorbs water, and forms feces. The last section of the intestine narrows to form an exit, or anus. Here, waste leaves its body. In the excretory system, the kidney filters out the lamprey's waste. The kidney helps regulate salt levels within the lamprey and the environment. This is crucial because of the change of habitat from freshwater to saltwater. In the ocean, the kidneys force the salt out of the body. It also utilizes the gills to get rid of the salt and allows the lamprey to let go of the salty urine. The circulatory and respiratory system, blood flows through a series of vessels to supply oxygen and nutrients to the body and to remove carbon dioxide and other waste. A lamprey breathes by extracting the oxygen present in the water in which it lives. Water is taken in by the mouth, passes through the pharynx, and proceeds to the respiratory tube. The lamprey actually has a pretty simple circulatory system because it has a heart with two chambers only. It has a single loop circulatory system. deoxygenated blood goes through one chamber and out the other as oxygenated blood goes through the lamprey's body. As it goes up, back to the gills and to be oxygenated again.
So, as you see, as I'm cutting Lance in half, you can see the gonads,
which tells us that
Lance is a boy. And, okay, just gonna
cut some more.
So here's the disgusting inside part of our Lance, the lamprey. So let's start with the tooth, which is right there, and then the papillae, and then the cranial cartilage, which is where its tiny, little bitty brain is, the tongue, which is used when it's sucking blood, the pharynx, the olfactory sac, the pineal gland, the brain, the malar tentacle, the branchial tube, the intestine, oh, and right there's the spinal cord, and as we mentioned before, because it's a guy, you can see its testes, the lingual muscle, the gills, the notochord, the myomeres, its tiny heart to go along with its tiny brain, the intestine, the liver, and that's basically it to Lance the lamprey. I think we got really lucky with our dissection because after cutting in half after 2 days, this is it. Which is why the lamprey has remained the same throughout millions, billions of years, and that's why it's a simple creature that just sucks your blood.
Thanks for watching.
Love you. Woo!
Yay. Bye. We're finished the school year. Yay!
But we're not done yet.
Yeah, we are.
What else is there?